By the way, if you're ever looking for a good cardio workout, become a conductor. Works great. So that was music, of course, from another classic holiday TV special, Dr. Seuss' How the Grinch Stole Christmas. In it, a cranky green monster and his long-suffering dog, Max, dress up as Santa and reindeer to sled down into Whoville on Christmas Eve. They steal all the presents, decorations, and food from the town, hoping to put an end to noisy Christmas forever. But the Grinch is amazed to hear the Who's singing joyously when they awaken on Christmas morning, and his shrunken heart expands as he realizes maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. Obviously, this speech is a little bit longer than I thought it would take for the singers to get into place. I was really, you know, thinking they would take their time. So now the Amuse singers will bring you a unique and slightly goofy arrangement of Tchaikovsky.
Ba 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 ba
So as I mentioned before, being a conductor is not only a good cardio workout, but it's also really, really fun. And I do highly recommend it. And I believe it doesn't get any more fun than conducting something as iconic as Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. So when I saw that there was a great arrangement of the music from Disney's Fantasia 2000, including Beethoven's favorite piece, I just had to do it. So I still haven't figured out how it fits into the theme of the holidays, except that it feels like a gift to play this fabulous music for you. So enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. dream. We got volleyball and ping pong and a lot of dandy games. What ain't we got? We ain't got days. There is nothing like a day. Nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name.
Oklahoma, but I love that song. So some fun facts about composer Richard Rodgers, which was the medley we just heard there. He wrote more than 900 songs, wrote 43 Broadway musicals, won multiple Emmys, Grammys, Oscars, Tonys, and even the Pulitzer Prize twice. As one of the most famous and influential musical theater composers of all time, his legacy continues not only in his music, but even in his family. His daughter, Mary, wrote the score for Broadway's Once Upon a Mattress, and his grandson, Adam Goitel, wrote the score for The Light in the Piazza. And now, we're going to transition from popular dramatic music of the 30s, 40s, and 50s to popular music from the 70s, and two songs from highly dramatic bands, The Beatles and Queen. Again, make up your own rationale as to why these are holiday songs.
Crazy little thing.
By the way, if you're ever stuck in traffic in LA, and who isn't, just sing Let It Be. It really helps. That's what I do. So next, we're going to go back to Broadway for Fiddler on the Roof. Now, the show debuted in 1964, telling the story of Tevye, a poor Jewish milkman, and his attempts to maintain his family traditions despite the encroachment of the outside world. It became one of the longest-running shows in history, and has been revived on Broadway 4 times. We will play a suite of the wonderful dance music from this show, Tradition, Wedding Dance, Perchik and Hoddle Dance, Hava Sequence, and To Life. And by the way, happy Hanukkah, first night of Hanukkah tonight. So now, Fiddler on the Roof, performed without any fiddles.
Thank you.
By the way, I just have to point out, fabulous clarinet solo, trumpet solo, euphonium solo, flute solo. Let's give them all a hand. That I like musicals. I like them. The movie musical Mary Poppins, with a score by the Sherman Brothers, was released in 1964 and received a whopping 13 Oscar nominations, the most of any Disney movie to date, and won 5, including Best Song and Best Score. And for our last piece on the program, hint, hint, we hear music from another movie musical, the stirring anthem from The Prince of Egypt. This 1998 film is a dramatization of the story of Moses and the tribes of Israel's deliverance from slavery in Egypt. The song, When You Believe, is sung as the Hebrews leave Egypt and begin their journey to a new land. Listen as the song itself is a journey, starting as a humble prayer and moving through many emotions to arrive at a full celebration of the power of hope. So this is When You Believe. I'm inspired. So thank you again. It's been our pleasure to share this music with you this afternoon. I'd like to take a moment to dedicate this concert to one of our dear friends who unfortunately could not be with us today, and that is Chantel O'Loughlin. Chantel is the music director at Palos Verdes Intermediate School, an alto in the Amuse Singers, and a force of nature. If you've ever met her, you know that's true. We miss her sass and wish her a speedy recovery so that she can get back to making music here on the Hill. And if you want to be part of making music on the Hill, I have three suggestions for you. One, if you like to sing, join us in Amuse Singers for rehearsals on Sunday nights starting in February. We sing at Amuse Music right here. If you play an instrument, consider joining the Peninsula Symphonic Winds. Their rehearsals are on Wednesday nights at Harbor College starting in January. Or make music happen by contributing to the Peninsula Symphonic Winds through their website at pswinds.org. You know, music is expensive. My husband knows, we have three daughters, they play a lot of instruments. So if you'd like to make a contribution, again, that's pswinds.org. But now, all of you can be a part of making music right now by opening your program to the inside back page and join us in singing the Christmas song. And if you don't have your programs, just do what, you know, my mom does in church. Make it up. It's all good. Here's the Christmas song. Please join in.
Thank you.
much. What a great afternoon. Thanks for being a part of it. And have a very safe and wonderful holiday season. God bless.